everyone. I'm Surabhi, the homeschooling mother of two precious little girls aged 4 and 3. And today I'm here again with a DIY using dot stickers and some waste paper which was left after cutting out some printables. So because I don't like things getting wasted, so I came up with this logical activity, visual discrimination activity, and some pre-writing activity. So what I had is I had some yellow paper which was left, I mean, after cutting some printables or some activity. So what I did is I laminated these two sheets. This is 4x4 and this is 3x3, you can see that. And I laminated these ones because here is one where my kid will be doing it. And these are the clue cards. So like I'll give this one and then she has to draw the same here. Okay, so these all are 4x4, so some are smaller one intentionally, so that, you know, see, for a child, she tried to do like this. Okay, so one, if it is like this, she really has to think how to make it. So that was my idea of challenging her in the thinking ability. And the same gun was going to be 3x3, so this is of almost the equal size, she can, you know, map it easily. But now this is smaller one, so that was a challenge planned for her. So this is first activity. This is a pre-writing one, so it's mainly for my 4-year-old. And this is, again, it is mainly for my 3-year-old because it's pretty simple. These are some leftover papers, you know, after cutting out some printable, and I have dot stickers. So I just made different color combinations. So I'll make these ones spread and then give her fine matching one. So just because of dot stickers and they're similar stickers, she has to figure it out. So it's visual discrimination. So we actually played it, and we played in two ways. One, I spread all of them. She has to find matching, which she could not do. I think she's pretty young for it. But my 4-year could do it easily. I spread everything and she matched, find the matching pairs. For my 3-year-old, I just took it like this and gave it to her, and then I had to help her out that, you know, look which color you don't have, and okay, there is no, because the colors are pretty matching, but still I have made sure that some cards like blue is missing, so I could, you know, guide her that, you know, your card does not have blue, so ignore all the cards there. So because there's so many cards, it got really overwhelming for her. So you can see how you're going to give it to your child, but these are the techniques I used. I gave her clues, I gave his hints, and I did 5 cards at a time sometime. That's also I did, but that's how we did this activity. This one is, I designed it for my 4-year-old, but she could not do it, so probably should be near about 5-year-old, I would say that, but depends on your child. But yeah, my 4-year-old could not do it, so I would not recommend that. So it's, again, it's a waste paper, and it's just 4x4 matrix, and I have used 4 colors, okay, but like this doesn't have red. Again, I'm using the same logic. So some cards do not have one particular color. Now this has red, this is all the colors, and it has like, I have made sure that some colors are missing in one or two cards to not make it so overwhelming. And if you see, there's always a pattern like this, so that, you know, which is easily to child recognize. So when I gave her clues to, you know, follow for a pattern which is very visually appealing, she could do 4 to 5 cards. But I have made 8 to 9 cards, and then she gave up that it was difficult for her. But yeah, this, you can give it a try. A complexity level, again, you can manage with your child's ability. But yeah, that's how it goes. So these are the 3 DIY activities with the waste paper and dot stickers, and happy parenting. Bye bye.